Dear aviators, imagine you're sitting in the cockpit after a successful flight. You decide to call it a day and announce your landing on the radio. Can you believe that the most dangerous turn in gliding is still ahead of you? The last turn into final approach is one of the most critical, potentially ending in a stall or spin close to the ground. In this video, you'll learn about the graveyard turn or over-ruddered turn, a maneuver responsible for many fatal accidents but often underrepresented in gliding training. But these stalls don't happen only just before landing. It is quite probably that during thermaling, a stall and spin might occur quite quickly. Witness in this flight how a glider stalls in a turn and how it can be recovered. Welcome on board and enjoy! So let's start with the standard exercise. I slow down the glider, wait for the shaking feeling when the turbulent airstream hit the elevator. I feel the controls getting soft and sloppy. I gently push the rudder to keep the glider in line. Then comes the moment when the glider wants to flip to one side. The airstream breaks off and one wing falls into the void. The glider stalls and my recovery program kicks in. Neutral aileron and elevator. Push the rudder against the spin direction and recover speed gently. Do you think this situation happens in real gliding life? Almost never. It is much more likely that this scenario happens in the final turn at low altitude or while thermaling. Now let's perform the same exercise but in a turn. Gently slow down the glider and try to maintain the angle of bank. The shaking feeling starts to come up. A gentle push on the left rudder initiates a skid and causes a stall. The wing drops much more aggressively and the glider tends to turn negative. The view from the cockpit is impressive, because there's nothing but the canopy below me. But again, the procedure for recovery. Less aileron and elevator and push the rudder against the spin direction. A quick check on the altimeters show that the recovery costs about 150 to 200 meters of altitude. This is why stalls in the traffic pattern can be so fatal. There's really no room for recovery, even if you're well trained. So keep your full attention on the last turns of your flight, and especially in thermals. What surprised me in this training was the much more aggressive stall entry when flying in a turn. This experience taught me a lot, and I highly recommend to test yourself with this exercise. I'm sure your flight instructor, in whom you trust, will be very happy to train this with you together. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please share, recommend, or leave a feedback. Your support means a lot. Take care and goodbye.